Alright, so I got the Battlefield 5 Alpha, or pre-alpha build thing, whatever you want to call it, and I didn't even apply for it, but whatever, I got it, and I'm making a video on it, so haha, yes. Anyways, let's get on with it. I have a couple gripes and a couple things that I thought was pretty good about the alpha there. First things first, the gunplay feels absolutely amazing. It is like playing 1942 again, but like on a grander scale. And I think this has something to do with the hit detection. It's actually really good for an alpha build. For some reason, it's like better than Battlefield 1 was even. Now, I will say though that the planes and the tanks are not as powerful as they once were. So this is a more infantry-based battlefield. And I don't think it's a bad thing by any means. I think it's a good thing for those who want a more tactical shooter. But those who liked Battlefield 1 probably won't like this nearly as much. Especially if you're a solo player. It is kind of sad though that there's no more giant blimps or horses that you can just have fun in, you know? Speaking of the vehicles in the game, I think the tanks and planes are really underpowered at the moment. The assault class is kind of OP at the moment as well, in the fact that you can take out a tank pretty much not by yourself, but if there's more than one assault player running the RPG, and this might change in the future when there's more equipment in the game to play around with, because right now it's basically the one rocket launcher and the Jeep stuff, for lack of a better term, the C4, the satchel charges. And when you're spamming the satchel charge and the RPG at the tanks, they go down very quickly, let's put it that way. They have almost no chance, and so you end up with all of the tanks standing in the very back of the spawns, just picking off people. So they don't go out and go for the objectives, and it ends up being just a solo pick off the players that can't get backed into your spawn. Also, the tanks and the planes don't have infinite ammo anymore. They don't automatically just reload. So you have to refill them at those supply stations that you get your ammo for your gun. And the planes, you have to fly through these little circles that have refill in them for some reason. I'm not entirely sure why there's not like a landing strip that you can land on, kind of like War Thunder. As for the infantry, it's very noticeable right off the bat that you don't have nearly as much ammo as you used to. In fact, you only start out with one magazine in your reserve. That's it. It is made up for, though, by how fast you die in the game, which is extremely fast. In my experience playing the game, you don't even have enough time to turn around when someone starts shooting you in the back. The new spotting system also doesn't really help with this, as you can't 3D spot anyone without using the flare gun, which I think the flare gun shouldn't even be in the game to begin with, because it just kind of defeats the purpose of having that more tactical 3D spotting mechanic. Another thing that's different from Battlefield 1 is that this game is a lot more squad orientated. Besides grabbing ammo and health from the supply stations littered around the flags, you can only get full ammo and full health from teammates, squad mates, and fallen enemies, of course. But it's a lot more necessary than in Battlefield 1. It's a lot more prevalent in this as well for you to be right next to a medic and they just don't revive you. I mean, that was the case in Battlefield 1, but it's a lot more noticeable in this one, because they'll be like 5 feet from you and then you just don't get picked up. And this is probably because it takes a lot longer to revive someone than it did in Battlefield 1. There's no instant revive of teammates from just like 5 feet away. By far the biggest gripe I have with the revive system, though, is the way you bleed out. You're basically just sitting there for about 10 to 20 seconds wondering whether to hold to call out for a revive. In my personal opinion, it kind of breaks the flow of the game, although dying is kind of supposed to do that in the first place, but not in Battlefield. It's supposed to be, you die, oh well, you respawn in about 10 seconds, whatever, no big deal, right? But it doesn't seem to do that in this. In its current state, it breaks the suspension of disbelief. And that is not a good thing. I, however, am not without solutions. So let me go over a couple of things that can help with these problems. You could obviously go back to the old revive system, but that would be backtracking and we want to do something new, right? I still think there should be an option to skip the revive. That way you can get to customize your classes sooner instead of having to wait that whole 10 seconds and then be able to customize your classes and then respawn. I think a good idea would be to be able to kill the person that you downed, basically. Kind of like the last stand in Call of Duty, the older Call of Duties. But in this, they wouldn't have a gun to actually fire back. That way you could make them skip the revive by killing them, you know? And the enemy player would obviously get extra points for finishing you off. I also want to mention that I don't like having just two magazines to start out with. I think it would be much more beneficial to have three to start out with and then go up to maybe four at a maximum. And I mean this including the one in your gun, not just the reserve. That extra mag can cause a world of difference when it comes to running out of ammo and then having to scavenge your fallen foes for ammo compared to having ammo and having that extra security blanket, let's say, for running out to grab that little pack of ammo. Overall, I think that lack of ammo slows down the gameplay a bit too much because people are forced to either camp for the next kill and basically run out and kamikaze knife somebody to be able to steal that ammo. It becomes a micromanaging game, for lack of a better term. I'm no developer though, so who knows? Maybe I'm completely wrong and none of this will matter and the game will play just fine how it is, but I thought I'd give my thoughts anyways. But hey, it never hurts to try, right? So maybe they can put some of this stuff in the CTE when the game comes out, and maybe it'll fix some of the problems. I don't know. But anyways, overall, the game is much, much, much better than the trailer lets on to be. So definitely going to pick it up when it fully releases, but I don't know what's going to be the same and what will change from the alpha here to the beta and to the full release. So a lot could change, and hopefully a couple of these things that I've mentioned here will be fixed or worked around to better fit the game. So anyways, that's been my review slash gripe fest of the game. So if you liked the video, please comment down below. I would love to hear from you. And I'm still working on that Q&A video, but I don't have enough questions to make anything yet. So really, leave a comment below asking a question if you want. You don't have to, obviously, but it'd be nice. So, thanks for watching, and have a wonderful day. Get hyper! Get hyper! Get hyper!